Now you can do the following. You can use template, internal newsletter, resume, business presentation, portfolio, DIY project. So there are some special features. You can use them. Or you can start from a topic. For example, you choose, so it is quite easy. You start a topic. Well, let me choose, so I have got dinosaur. Here I have got dinosaur. So I want to create a sway on dinosaur. I create outline. And now you will see Wikipedia helps to create my sway. So I have got a picture, a heading, a title of my book. It's also like a book, a presentation. Then I have got some text. The text is made by cards. You see some definitions, pictures, some history. I've got a great presentation on dinosaur. A huge presentation on dinosaur. Even the links are here. So you see this text, this presentation is based on Wikipedia, I guess. And you can see the pictures here. When you have no time, it is very easily to be presented for the classroom, for children, for example. Now, this is quite a new feature. It appeared maybe this year. You can start from a topic. You can start from a document. You can start from a document. This is also a new feature. And in my Wakelet, you can see a very good video. An educator demonstrates how to create a sway starting from a document. But maybe he has got another office because there are no such features like in his video on my computer. I will show you how I start from a document. I click start from a document. I have got a Word, Microsoft Word text, and I want to make it a presentation. Well, let me start. Why is it frozen? All right, so I will, just a second, I will upload the page. So first I will show you how to create a regular sway for you to understand what a sway is. A sway is a presentation made of separate cards and you can arrange the cards in any order. So create new. It is like cards, a pile of cards. So I need to have a title. Let it be Krasnoyarsk. I'm creating a presentation on my city. Krasnoyarsk. I have got some pictures on my computer. Krasnoyarsk. This is the title, the book cover. I can emphasize the word. I can make it bold. I can accent the word, make it italics, and I can add a link. Now I will go to Wikipedia, for example. Krasnoyarsk. And I can the wiki link to my presentation. So Krasnoyarsk on Wikipedia. I copy the link. It is very good when you create material for students. When your students make projects, a teacher should collect some materials for students. And you can create such collection for students when they begin their project work. So I have got my my sway, and look, I can add the link here. I paste, and you can see the word Krasnoyarsk is hyperlinked. It is a hyperlink. You see, now I want to add a background, a picture. I click on this background, and on the right appears suggested list. You see Krasnoyarsk. I have got pictures of Krasnoyarsk here. I open. Well, I choose this picture. I like it. I click and add. Or I can do it this way. I can drag it. I can drag another picture. If I don't need these pictures, I delete the cards. I delete them, yes. Now I start creating my sway. I click on the plus button and I want a heading, subheading. Let it be history. Let it be architecture. Architecture. I will call the subtitle architecture. Architecture. And again, I can emphasize the word. I can accent it. I can add a link. And now I also want to drag a picture, but I will use my suggested list. Suggested. I can use from Sways. I can use OneDrive. I can use YouTube. I will use my device. So on my device, I have got some pictures. I have got some pictures on Krasnoyarsk. Just a second. Yes, I have got some pictures on Krasnoyarsk. And yes, and I will download the picture. This is how I download the picture from my computer. I can use it from this. Oh, by the way, you see 10 ruble banknote and Krasnoyarsk hydropower electric station is on the banknote. So yes, and you can see the smog over Krasnoyarsk. We are suffering from bad environment. So these are the pictures. Now I want to add a text. Architecture, this is the heading. So this is an image. I can write a caption to the image. When you have an image, you don't write big text because they will cover the picture. I will just write a 10 ruble banknote. Banknote. I usually emphasize the pictures, the text. And here, okay, I will not add anything. Now I go on, I click. Now I want to add a text. I'm going to add a text. Text, I click text. Now I start writing. I start writing the text. I write the text, then I can emphasize accent, I can make it bulleted list. I click on bullets. I can change it to numbered list, numbers. I can add a hyperlink, again, a web link, cancel. Or, well, I don't know about this. Maybe I can make it bigger or smaller. Yes. I can make the letters bigger or smaller. I can delete the card. So let us have a look. We have got our presentation. How many cards? The heading, the title, the subheading, the image, and the text. So this is, we have got 4 cards. Now I'm going to add a video. I click on the plus button and I add media. Video. Now you see, I have got videos on Krasnoyarsk here. Let me choose this one. Welcome to Krasnoyarsk. Again, I just drag very easily. You can't do it this way on PowerPoint presentation, but you can do it this way here. And when your PowerPoint presentation is very heavy, you cannot download it. And this one, is not heavy because it is in cloud technologies. All right, so I have got a video. Now I want to add images, more images. So image. So look, I can add some images from here. I can add a lot of images. I just drag them and drag them. You see, I have got a number of images here very easily. I can rearrange them. I can move them easily around. I can rearrange the pictures, the slides, the cards, so to say. Now, what else can I do? I can, when I work with pictures, I can work with focus point. What it means. So, shall I show the whole picture? The entire image is important. I click the entire image. Then the whole picture will be seen. So, Yes, the entire picture is important. Now, what else can be done here? When I add images, I can select a pack. I can add images in a pack. Oh, let it be, so they will be grouped in a stack. For example, again, I download images from my suggested list. I click on the images and I search. Image, yes, I search images, let it be again on my computer. And I choose several pictures. Yes, I choose 1, 2, and 3. 3 pictures, they come in a pile. You see, they come in a group, in a pile. So I have created my text, my pictures, my headings and the titles. Now I'm going to create the style for my presentation, design. It is very easy to choose a style. So I used to show vertical style, but now I enjoy slides. So it is not very, it's not good to show horizontal. So it's sometimes it doesn't work. I choose either vertical style or slides. I choose slides, and now I will choose designs. Well, I like different, I like to change designs. Every time I choose one more style, another style. Now, before I play, I remind Mary Baby how to share my presentation. So my presentation is ready. I'm going to share it. If I want you to view, to see my sway, you have this link, view. And if I want you to edit the link, to be my co-pilot, to be my collaborator, to make a project with me, if you are my student and we are making a class project, then I click edit link and I share this link with you. And sometimes my students create their own sways at home and I ask them to invite me editor because I correct their mistakes. I say, if you don't invite me to edit, then I cannot correct your mistakes. And if you invite me to collaborate, I will be your editor. I will edit your work for publication. Now I'm going to play. I'm going to play my presentation. You see it is in slides. This is the text on the picture. So yes, here is a video. You can click on the video. Some more pictures. So this is this style. Now I want to change